नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू विद आवर चैप्टर नंबर 6 एचसीएफ एंड एलसीएम एक्सरसाइज 6E पार्ट नंबर 7 पेज नंबर 51। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी लर्नड अबाउट एलसीएम यूजिंग द टू प्रोसेसेस, यूजिंग मल्टीप्लिकेशन टेबल एंड बाय प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन। आई होप दैट यू हैव अंडरस्टूड एंड you have completed your work. Now we will do problem sums related to LCM of exercise 6E. So all of you take out your junior maths book 5 and open at page number 51. 1A, I am not writing the sum, you look at the book. Find the smallest number which when divided by 14 and 21 leaves no remainder. That means we have to find out the smallest number that is divisible completely, divisible by 14 and 21. There will be no remainder. So a number that is divisible by, what are the numbers? 14 and 21 has to be a multiple of each number. Clear? Now, so the smallest number that is divisible by 14 and 21, okay, is their LCM. As it is said, the smallest number. So, LCM is the lowest common multiple, that is the lowest means smallest. As it is said that we have to find out the smallest number, we have to do the LCM of the given numbers. Now, I am rubbing this one. It was 14 and 21. I will do the LCM over here using the prime factorization method. Whatever method you want, you can do between these two methods. 14, we will divide 14 by 2 as it is an even number. Then 7 is an odd number and 7 is divisible only by 7. 21, it will not be divisible by 2, it will first be divisible by 3. And 7 comes as quotient, 7 is divisible by 7. So, therefore, 14 is equal to 2 into 7 in 7. And here, 21 is equal to 3 into 7. Now, I told you before, in prime factorization method, we have to keep each factor the greatest number of times it occurs in the number whose LCM is to be found. So, here you can see that 2 and 3. Therefore, the LCM of 14 and 21 is 2 and 3 occurs one time. So, you will take 2 and 3, 2 into 3. And here 7. We will take 7, 1. So, our answer comes as 42. So, your answer will be, then how you have to write the answer? So, answer will be the smallest number, that is divisible by 14 and 21 is 42. Clear? Now, sum number 1B, 2A and 2B are same as sum number 1A. So, sum number 1B, 2AB, you will do by yourself. Now, I will go to sum number 3. What is that? Find the smallest number. GB I am reading. You look at GB. Find the smallest number which, when reduced by 2, becomes divisible by 24, 48 and 64. Reduced by 2, that means which, when divided by 24, 48 and 64, leaves 2 as remainder. Reduced by 2, that means there will be remainder as 2. So how we will do that? 3B. First, we find out the smallest number. That is divisible by, what are the numbers? 24, 48 and 64. That means smallest number. First we have to do the LCM of these three numbers. 24. Now I think you have understood this process now. I am now not explaining this. Then 64. Again 2. Now I'm grabbing this one, otherwise it will not be fitted. Therefore, 24 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Therefore, 48 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Then 64 is equal to, how many 2's are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Clear? Now, therefore, the LCM of 24, 48 and 64 is, we have to take the greatest number that occurs the more times, greatest times. Here you can see that 6 times 2 occurs. So we will take 2 into 2 into 2 okay, and here 3. Greatest time, it is 1 and it is also 1, we will take 3. So, 192. 192. Clear. Now, so the smallest number. I am running this portion again. So the smallest number, which when divisible by, what are the numbers? 24, 48 and 64 leaves. You can see that it is written reduced by 2. That means 2 as remainder. Reduced by 2, that means 2 as remainder. This thing you have to remember. Is equal to, you will, what you have to do? You have to simply add 2 with the number that comes as LCM. That is 194. When it is said that reduced or leaves the remainder, if it is no remainder, so well and good, you will just do the LCM. But when it is said that there is remainder or reduced by some number, that time after doing the LCM, you have to add that number. Clear? So in this way, you have to do the sum if there is remainder or reduced by any number. So your work, sums to be done in maths class or copy. Exercise 6E. Sum number 1B, 2AB and 3A. 3B I have done, but to do 3A. The students, today up to this much. In our next class, we shall meet again. Till then, Namah Shivaya, students.